no matter what you want to buy. You'll find it all on the Hub.
The SME Market Hub. Buy, sell, list, connect.
Hello, Obi. I was just...
Yeah, I need to... I think I know who killed the FCC guy, and they're after
me.
And I'm losing my mind.
Slow down. You're not making any sense. How could you possibly...
Adi.
I trust you.
That's why I'm calling you. I can, right?
What?
Trust you?
Of course.
All right. This is going to sound real crazy. I don't even know where to begin.
You know what? I don't think
we should talk about this over the phone.
Yes,
you're right. You never know who's listening.
Come on, Obi. I think you've been watching far too many conspiracy movies. You know what? Just come by
the office tomorrow and we'll talk about it.
I'm not crazy, Ade. This is real.
Don't worry. Just come by the office tomorrow.
Hey, beautiful.
Hey. You're all dressed?
Yeah, I have a few errands to run. Meet up with my aunt later before I leave.
I should leave. I need to go to mine to pack and tidy things at the shop.
Don't worry, take your time. I'll pick you up, say, 6. Okay. In a few hours, we'll be in Milan. We'll be away from all of this. At least for a few months. See you later.
Daddy.
Now we celebrate.
You know, Mo was not washy at all. You really are amazing. This could not have happened without you.
Well, it was a lot of hard work, but I enjoyed every bit of it. You know, I don't mean to be forward, but seeing you and Mo and how you work together and your friendship, why aren't you guys together?
Together?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's really none of my business. I'm sorry. But You guys are just perfect for each other.
You know, Mo means the world to me, but we're just really, really good friends.
It's 11 a.m., Tokunbo. Is this what you spend your time doing? I mean, no wonder...
Please,
Dad, what?
Please stop. I just can't deal with it. Let's just not...
Tokunbo! It's 11 a.m. And while the whole world is striving hard to make a living, you are sitting down here looking like a tout. Eating and watching video games. Let me not even start with whatever it is that you've been smoking. I don't blame you. It's your mother I blame. I mean, ever since you were a little boy, she has spoiled you, silly. Always letting you to have your way. And now, just look at you.
Yes, Dad. We all know how much of a disgrace you think I am to you and how much shame that I've brought to you, so...
What parent would like to see his son like this? I mean, with all your potential, Tokunbo, you allow this, your hard head and lack of discipline to get in your way.
Trust me, I already feel like a failure. And I'm very aware of my fault. So if that's why you came here to tell me this, then you better just...
Okay. So fair, Lemini.
All right, sir.
I remember when you were just a little boy, about 7 or 8 years old. We changed your school. And when you started attending the new school, you found it hard to make friends at first. So we signed you up for the Boy Scout. You were such a small boy for your age. Not this tall and big macho man that you have become. You were so small and skinny. I remember when one day you came back home from school and announced that you had changed to the football team. You would come home often with bruises and sprained ankle. And your mom would almost kill the teachers for allowing you to continue to play. But no, you just would not quit. And you know what happened.
I became the captain of the team.
Yes. That is the Tokunbo I know. You are fearless. Always have a mind of your own. I know most of the time I can't understand your decisions. And I try to protect you from moments like this. But Tokunbo, achieving greatness is not easy. If it were, everyone would be great. If you wanted a simple life, you should have accepted the job I got for you.
I just don't know where to start. It took me 6 years to get here. And in less than 6 months, I lost everything. Just 6 years of my life wasted.
Tokunbo, I want you to look at it in another way. It's taken you 6 years to learn what not to do, so that when you start again, you are so much wiser.
Never know who's listening.
To the most talented, beautiful...
Me?
Yes, you. Don't interrupt my speech, Joe. And bravest woman I know. I've always known you to be great, but in the past few weeks, totally blown my mind.
And you have mine. You know, without you, I probably would not have been brave enough to even start. You know, I'd reached the lowest point of my life. And I couldn't tell you then, but...
Don't. Come on now. Come on, chill, stop. Listen, hey, today's a happy day, you know? I'm so proud of you. You achieved so much, babe. Come on. No crying. Unless you want me to dance.
Please don't dance.
You better. Listen. I've been meaning to ask you something. I was kind of wondering if you could come over to mine for dinner tonight.
Why are you being weird?
I'm not being weird, Joe. Will you?
Of course I'll come.
So, how do you like your new business partner?
Business partner.
Me. I'd like to invest in TechSouth.
You're joking, right?
Why should I joke about such a thing? I believe in you, Tokunbo. I may have been blind to it at first, but now I know that this is what you are passionate about. All I want for you is to be successful and to be happy.
I can't believe it. Thank you so much.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I can't thank you enough, Dad.
Don't. I should have done this sooner. I was so proud of you when I read your Forbes article. And so ashamed that it had to take a magazine article for me to realize how passionate you are about what you do.
I can't believe this is us. Let's see how we're talking like...
Hey, I have to release the driver soon so that he will go and collect some things for your mom before it's too late.
Oh, no. Just send him off. I can take you home.
That your car is for big men.
Daddy. I guess some things will never change.
You are really something.
Oh my
God, you startled me.
I can honestly say that I didn't see this coming, and trust me, I can typically tell anyone's next three moves are, but this...
Sharon, I can...
What? Explain? Mm-mm. Don't say anything. No, like really, what were you thinking? So you had an affair with my father, whose PA almost got you killed. Then I basically saved you from the obscurity that your life is. Then you thought, after everything you thought, I'm going to steal her fiancé. Like really? As if sleeping with my father was not enough. You're one hell of a twisted
bitch. It's not even like that. We didn't plan this. In fact, we tried to stop it. But I guess it just happened. Please, Sharon, you have to understand that neither of us was trying to hurt you.
You're now an us? No, Yvonne, I don't have to understand anything. Do you really think that you and Mecca are going to ride off into the sunset and live happily ever after? You're so pathetic. Mecca and I have known each other since we were kids. We have been through way more than you can wrap your stupid little head around. Mecca is the love of my life. And yes, he might be getting pre-wedding jitters and he feels like he needs some distraction, but he's my soulmate. So if you think a couple of shags on a weekend getaway can compare or replace 20 years of love, friendship, and basically sharing our lives together, you're even way more stupid than I thought.
Fine, I deserve that.
No. What you deserve is to be treated like filth, because that's exactly what you are.
Sharon, there's no need for this. I made a mistake once. Okay, twice. But this is different. We have feelings for each other. I honestly never meant to hurt you. I wouldn't dare. You've been so generous to me, and I know we've had our differences in the past, but...
Everything is such an act with you, isn't it? You are such an ungrateful bitch. All you do is ruin everything and everyone around you. Well, this time you messed with the wrong person. I will make it a personal aim to ruin every shred you consist of. Let me be clear. I never miss.
Adi. Thank you for seeing me.
Hello, Obi.
Rather elaborate.
Yeah, I aim to please.
Well, it smells amazing.
Thank you, thank you.
How are you going to be such an amazing cook?
Hey, you know, I learned from the best.
Your dad, right?
Yep, yep. Man was such a foodie.
And your parents just adopt you. They are the cutest.
Well, you do know. There is another way you can join the family. Thoughts that I burnt in the house in moments when I am in doubt. My phone's put your 12 digits out, but it's deleted now. My baby got lost in the crowd. I can't
stay to hear you. It's the wrong thing to do.
It's the wrong thing to do, girl. It's the wrong thing to do.
So, how are the girls?
Girl?
Yes, ma'am. When are you going to introduce our future daughter-in-law to mom?
You sound just like mom right now. She's always on my case too.
What is happening?
I don't know. I think there's something wrong. Got to fix my spare tire. I know. I'll go get a vulcanizer. I'm sure there's one around here somewhere.
Be careful.
I'll be back in a few minutes. Okay. Ross, I beg, is there any vulcanizer around here?
Just go down this way.
Down this way?
Yeah, down.
Okay, thanks.
I know what you're going to say, but my mind is already made up. I want to be with Yvonne, Auntie, more than anything in this world.
How can you want to throw away your relationship with Sharon over someone you barely even know?
I know her well enough. I know that I want to be with her, and I like who I am when I'm with her. I mean, she...
Emeka, please don't be a fool. This girl has you wrapped around her finger, and you're too stupid to realize that all she's doing is manipulating you. Girls like Yvonne are only after one thing. Money. That's all you are to her. A ticket to a way of life that she can only dream about. Goodness, Emeka, your mother will be completely...
Enough, Auntie, enough. I love and I respect you, but I'm tired of being emotionally blackmailed into every decision. You don't even know Yvonne, and yet you've already made up your mind about her. I am old enough to make my own decisions. So if I'm making a mistake, then so be it. It is mine to make.
Darling, I didn't want to be the one to have to tell you this, but your Yvonne was involved with Sharon's father.
What? It's a lie.
Why would I lie? Ask her.
So, Tokunbo, how was it? Were you able to...
What?
I can't believe you still have this.
Of course I do. I'm a 90s baby.
Hi, Rosie. Can I have a dance?
Hey, Rosie. Can I have a dance? Are you feeling the mood? Hey, baby girl.
Okay. Can I have a dance?
Rosie, your friends are watching me. Rosie, can you have a dance for me? Rosie, can you have a dance? Rosie, God have mercy. It is me, Mr. Mo.
Mr. Black.
Can I have a dance? Come on, get there, sir. My friends are watching me. Rosie, can you laugh off of me? Rosie, why are you laughing at me? My friends are laughing and you're laughing.
What are you talking about today, George?
stay away from my sister.
It's my job, Ephra, keeping secrets. Sorry,
Warren. Hello, what are you?
Good evening, ma. We have him.
Yours is perfect.
What would you like us to do with him?
All that I have. 5,000 naira with your wristwatch. Baba, you are lying.
No, honestly, I don't
give
have
me your ring.
My ring? My wedding ring? What is that to you? It's nothing to you now.
Give me your belt. Even your shoe.
What?
I didn't play.
Now, look here, young man. I mean, what do you need all that for?
I don't wanna be